Now, here's a really useful feature that we want to talk about. It is the deinterleaving or kind of emitter identification capability within the pulse analysis software. So once again, we have about 130 pulse capture here. And we can see our pulse table of all the different types of modulated pulses with varying pulse widths and frequencies and such. And what we want to look at is how can we calculate different values of pulses that are or pulse trains that are interleaved. Whereas there might be pulse trains that are consecutive in here, but there might be interleaved pulse trains. So for example, let's find a pulse of interest and be able to ca automatically calculate the PRI in between it. So I'm going to use my marker. I got markers on both traces here that are coupled. Just in case, you can use the marker tool here and drop a marker, and then you can go to the markers window and select couple markers. So this wider pulse here looks of interest, and I immediately know based on the application that this is pulse number 13. So here's pulse number 13, and I want to calculate the PRI from every time that that pulse occurs. And if you've seen some of the previous videos, you know that this is a recurring pulse. So let's find a way to do that. So let's go to Measurement Setup, Pulse Properties, into Analysis, and then go to Deinterleaving. So here I can select up to 14 different emitters, or actually a few more than that, up to 30 different emitters. And so I'm going to turn on emitter 1. And I want to say that emitter 1, I want to set it up such that it captures the window of this particular pulse. So frequency, I know that it's about minus 20. So I want to capture all the pulses that are between, say, minus 22 megahertz and we'll say minus 18 megahertz. And I think they'll capture all of the pulses similar to this. And for amplitude, I'm not going to worry about amplitude because our amplitudes are changing a bit. So I'm going to turn on frequency and see if we're able to capture that. Not quite, but I know that this is triangular FM. So I'm going to change the modulation type to triangular FM and select that on. So I should be able to capture that. And I do. So we can see that it's highlighted here. And this green highlight, again, is color coordinated to what we had here in our pulse analysis menu for emitter 1, green. If we chose to set this up under a different emitter profile, it would be this corresponding color. So now, what's really useful is that you see the PRI calculation in the pulse table went away for virtually every other pulse except for the one that we singled out. This is incredibly useful in the sense that now we know what the PRI is in between each subsequent capture of that specific pulse. So it's about 440 microseconds. And we can double check this by adding, we'll add a second marker on our main trace here, and we'll make that a delta marker with respect to marker 1. And I believe so this happened at pulse 13 and then at pulse 32. So here we can see we just so happen to place our marker at pulse 32. I'm going to try to put that on the leading edge of that marker or on the leading edge of that pulse, and I feel like that's pretty close there. Getting in a little bit closer, and then we'll move this guy closer to the leading edge. And actually, we can hone in here. And do we get about 440 microseconds? Let's go back to our delta marker. And sure enough, we're at 437. So I'm probably a little off on how I'm placing my markers here, but that just validates this was able to automatically identify the same pulse in a field of many pulses and be able to recalculate the PRI to give us a very accurate value. And it helps us just easily see how often that happens for those particular pulses or quote emitters, as well as the timing of those on how often they happen. So this is a really powerful tool, and you can see you could do this for a wide range of different emitter windows. So you could discriminate based on frequency, based on amplitude differences, based on modulation. So this really helps for near versus far emitters, maybe frequency agile versus fixed frequency emitters, or something in between. Different modulation emitters. So provides a useful way to pull them apart and categorize them, not necessarily because their mode changes or had a certain series of pulses that occurred, like we saw with train scoring or train identification, and we're not seeing how well they match previous pulses or reference pulses like pulse scoring, but just to find and parse out emitters based on amplitude and frequency and modulation. So really interesting tool to help more accurately and quickly automate some PRI calculations for some complex and dense pulse environments.